Okay, and now I like to show you that why this my PC laptop computer is not working, and there is really issue that there is no any electricity inside in this my computer, and now I am thinking that there is maybe this battery is dead. And how I can test that this my laptop's computer's battery is dead? Okay, firstly I have to little bit disassemble this part, and let's go to do next this disassemble things that we can see the battery. Okay, and then when I start to open and disassemble this PC laptop cover, I need to know just that what size of this drill bit I need, because there are those small screws in all of these small holes in that way, like this. I have now opened one of those, but then when we go to look a little bit deeper in here, we can find all of these holes. There's one screw, and now I have to open these bolts, and let's go to look that how I open like that screw in here. Okay, and now when we look in their inner area, there's really screw, and this my drill bit fits in here, and let's go to look closer. Okay, and now we can see in their inner that there is screw, and now I install this my drill bit in here, and then my screwdriver, and then I start to rotate that in this way, and soon this screw is open. And now we can look also better view. Okay, now I am removing this my screw, and now it is open. And there is that kind of screw in there inside, and same size like in here, in a little bit another way. And now I have to remove all of these screws in this area, and there is next screw in here, and I rotate that. There is screw, and then I can use also this electric drill in that way. There is this drill bit, and there is similar drill bit, and there is screw in here. And now when I like to open that, it is very fast with using this electric drill bits, and there is the screw. Okay, and now I take next all of these screws in here away. There is next in here. There is that one. Next one. And then, when I have removed all of these screws, we can go to through and check that there is no any screws left. Okay, and now we check that all of these screws are away. There's no any screws. No in there, no. Looks good. There is none in there. Okay, and now when all screws are away, I can start to take that cover out. And now I have this paper knife, and I plan to install this my knife in between of the black one, and then in that area, and I carefully bend this area, and now it opens, look. Now it starts to open in here. And then I have to carefully move my keyboard out, and in that way I carefully move that in this way, in that way, and then a little bit force. Look that in the inner area, there's no any cables in there. And that area. Now I check that. That I can open that more. Okay, and now when I have carefully handle that and I rotate that in another direction. Now I manage to open that, and now I carefully move that area, and then we have in here these cables, like in that one, and I have to carefully pull out these cables in that way, and now these cables away, and there is that cables also away, and then we can see in the inner area, and now this my keyboard, it is free. There are those connector cables and metallic parts. This looks good. Okay, excellent. And then we can look in that inner area in here next. Okay, and now when I have made this disassemble, I can see this computer inside area, and there is this screen, and there are those components. And in that area we have this keyboard, and then we need to find this battery. And battery is normally one big component, like in that one. And now I believe that this area is battery, and let's go to look that area closer. Okay, and now we can see that battery, and there are those cables, and now when I little bit move that area normally, I can take that battery out in this way, in that way, carefully, and then it is important to check that what kind of information we have in here, because then we can know more that how to test that battery. And now I install in here this I install in here one support plate that we can look this informations, and let's go to look then this data. Okay, and now when we are looking for that battery, we can firstly see that maker is Asher, and there is this product code, but now I am planning to look that what is voltage of this battery, and there should be this voltage what is 14.8 voltage, and also I can see in here that there are small markings in here that charging voltage is higher, 17.4, and now that means that when I test that this my battery, I have to see when I test that there is at least this 14.8 is this voltage in here, and this battery, it must keep that voltage when I have charged this battery in full using my this charger. There is my this charger. When I use this charger, I have to charge that like couple of hours, and then I have to test that is there really this voltage what is in here, 14.8 voltage. Okay, and how to test that what is my this current battery status, and it happens so that I have to little bit take these plastic papers away, and in inside we can see these big batteries in there. Look, one battery in here, second and third, and now I have to connect this my, and we look in that area, we can see that there is one and two those big areas in here when I have to where I can take this voltage. And let's go to look these areas next. Okay, and now when we are looking inside this battery area, we can see in just in here that there is small metallic pin in here and another one in here. And now I have to take my testing equipment, and I will test this currency and this voltage between of those two points, and for that measurement I need this my electric basic tester, and now I have to install this my testing equipment. This is standard tester where must have these two testing this pin, red one and black one. And now I change this my settings, and now I test this voltage. And there is this amount, there is 9 voltage in here, and this is my this information, and switch is in there, and now it seems that there is like 0 voltage. And now I have to connect these my two cables. First one in that area, in here. And now I am looking for that what voltage there is inside, and second in here. And now we can also look that my voltage meters, this amounts, because it is important. Now we can see these numbers in here, and now I connect these my cables. Let's look first one in here and second in here. And now there is voltage what is really small. Look that amount in here. I take a little bit better view. We can see, look that voltage in here even closer, and there should be 14.8 voltage. Okay, and let's look at what I can get in there and in there. What is my voltage amount? It is now 6.3 is this voltage in here. Look that amount in here. First one is in here and second in here. And now this voltage is too small, and we can also look at what are those points where I am installing in there, and I install in my settings in these points, and then I can see this voltage amount in here, and I can test in many places in here, and that when I am looking at this voltage, and now I have actually better area where I tested in this outer area. There is this, and there is 12.79. This is this right amount in here. I was a little bit wrong, but it is still too weak. And if we have voltage what is like 12 voltage, then I need to replace this full battery package in new one. And now it seems that in my case this battery is too weak, and that's I have to replace that battery. And now when this is so professional connection, I need to take this my laptop to this professional serviceman that he can replace this battery. And now I have showed to you that how I can test and notice that this my computer's battery is too weak and bad. And in my case we can see that this is really so bad, this my battery. Okay, and thumbs up my friend, and now you have learned that what is this battery's status. Thank you.